As you probably already know, people with blood group O can give blood to all other groups. Namely, in the erythrocytes of the blood group O, there is no factors that destroy someone else's blood. This means that they can give blood to all other groups but receive blood only from their blood type. This makes them pretty special. The O type blood is the blood type of the generations that existed before us, the generation that showed us the way. They were survivors of whatever nature put them through. This made the blood type itself to be a sign and symbol of leadership qualities. Even today, people with this particular blood type are believed to be more productive than the average person. Keeping all of this aside, it is no surprise that certain unfavorable external factors can be detrimental to the health of people with type O blood. They are prone to issues like diabetes, thyroid, and morbid obesity. The factors that might contribute to the above-mentioned issues could range from stress, anger issues, being overworked, and many more. Insulin resistance is one of the major issues that might pose considerable threat to the well-being of these people that can also be caused by the same factors. Health problems like stomach ulcers and iodine deficiency are not very far away when you have the O-type blood either. These hormonal imbalances can also cause major problems like tumors that cause pain and inflammation. All in all, O-type blood does come with a fair amount of caution. Why is it so unique? It is a good idea to know your blood type. Many Japanese people believe that each blood type has a certain personality and affinity, so it is common for them to ask someone their blood type or try to guess someone's blood type by their personality. Exceptional qualities like leadership, commitment, responsibility, organization, etc. are associated with this particular blood type. It is a general and widespread belief that people with O-type blood are better at drawing detailed and functional plans and actually sticking to them and getting the work done. They are perceptive and understand their environment and surroundings better than other people and make sure that they do things accordingly, avoiding setbacks and other issues. They make better evaluation of whatever issue they have at hand. As mentioned earlier, O-type blood comes with its own set of issues too. People with this type of blood are more likely to get heart diseases as well as be victim of other hormonal issues. They can prone to all kinds of dysfunction, ranging from thyroid to a higher amount of stomach acid. They also sometimes fall prey to iodine deficiency, which causes a number of stomach issues, starting from irritation to ulcers. It is quite safe to say that all these above issues might have a common cause: stress. Stress often stems from anger. People with O-type blood are psychologically bent towards a number of issues and almost negligible impulse control. This pretty naturally leads to many other problems, like unnecessary risk-taking, which in turn leads to harmful habits like gambling and dangerous hobbies. To keep and be in good health, all it would take for these people would be avoiding alcohol and caffeine, as both of these affect adrenaline levels in our bodies. A sedentary lifestyle is not particularly advisable, as a cautionary measure. A healthy routine with moderate amount of exercise with a balanced diet would be enough for people with O-type blood to lead healthy and happy lives. Everyone with O-type is genetically blessed to be a step ahead of their peers in almost every possible sphere, as long as they understand their health and consider it before doing something rash. Our ancestors, who paved the way for us, using their genius, had this particular blood type, which is proof enough of the fact that the pros outweigh the cons of having this particular blood type. Thank you, and may this information useful for you.